Why do I have my sable on right now? I'm really hope the only thing I'm really hoping for is that they show the Switch Pro. That's all I'm hoping for. Yeah, but overall, I'm scared that this E3 is just going to end in absolute tragedy. I'm scared out of my mind, dude. Yeah, like after Steve, man, like I have trauma, and I'm just scared of every Smash reveal from that point forward. Oh, here we go. Here we go, guys. It's a little loud.
Hello, everyone. I'm Shinya Takahashi, and I'll be your guide for today's Nintendo Direct.
Hello, I'm Yoshiaki Koizumi, and I'll be your guide as well.
Appreciate that, Doc, man.
The Nintendo Switch system is now in its fifth year, and many people around the world are playing games on it. Nintendo Switch is being enjoyed by a wide range of players spanning all ages.
Let me know if that's good,
all
guys.
All levels of gaming experience. Thank you all very much. We've been able to offer a wide variety of games on the system.
We good?
Not just from Nintendo, but also from our many development and publishing partners. I hope that each of you watching this Nintendo Direct...
Fuck yeah, I'm putting on Max.
...a game that suits your personal tastes.
Today, we have news on upcoming Nintendo Switch games.
I ain't seen you in a minute, dude.
We'll be focusing on a selection of games releasing this year. We hope you enjoy it.
That's not true. It's just
okay,
the opening.
To begin, please take a look at this video.
Pro. Switch Pro. Oh no, this is Smash. This is Smash. This is Smash. Oh, or. Wait, huh? Tekken! It's Tekken, dude. That's the fucking. Oh, you know this motherfucker's gonna be busted. Oh my god. Like it's cool. Like I'd be okay with it. If Sakurai was just able to develop them correctly. You know what I mean? But like it's a cool inclusion. But I can't help but to think about the implementation. It's the implementation that's like scaring me. You know what I mean? But hey, yeah, like not Jonesy, not his owner. I'll take it. It's a dub overall. It's a dub overall. I'll take it. It could be a lot worse. It could be so much worse. And it's not Jin, at least. They might show the second character. They might still show the second one. You threw the whole cast into the fucking lava. Another auto turnaround character. That's the thing that's getting me, man. And it's not Heihachi either. Yeah, thank God it's not that motherfucker. No, you can't do that to Kirby. No. Oh, he's just gonna puff back up. Watch. Yeah. Yeah.
Hello, I'm Masahiro Sakurai from Sora Limited and the director of the Super Smash Bros. Ultimate game. Kazuya Mishima from the
Fighting
Game
series.
Oh no,
they're not about to spend like 15 minutes on it, are they?
Surprise!
That's not good.
I'll go over the details at a later date.
Okay,
so please sit tight.
Okay, I got scared
for
a second.
Today, though, we've prepared a short video to showcase Kazuya's moves in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate.
I was scared he's about to do his rundown like right now. Yeah, just showing the moves is fine. Yeah, good note so far. Like, I'm still scared that this character's gonna be toxic as fuck, but the character itself is fine. I am fine with his inclusion. One character left. Yo, they better have Infinite Assurance. Yo, Infinite Assurance Smash? Oh, shit. He has to have that track.
Like Tekken. No, it's Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. I'll talk about the fighter more in a future presentation. We still have to record it first, actually. The air date is shown below.
Okay.
Please stay tuned.
Thank you, Mr. Sakurai.
I'm scared.
New fighter Kazuya will join the fight in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Please look forward to seeing how Kazuya, who has experienced many harsh battles across the Tekken series, will fight in this game.
That's absolutely.
All right, let's continue with our first match for Nintendo Switch headlines.
It could.
Your choices matter in these emotional, supernatural
tales. Oh, this is gonna be something I don't care about. I'm still expecting Jonesy. Jonesy's gonna be the last one, dude, I'm telling you. Yeah. Don't
Life
care.
Is True Colors launches on Nintendo Switch September.
Don't care.
And Life is Strange Remastered Collection comes to Nintendo Switch later.
I'll go
this
to
year.
The movie theater for that shit. I'm good.
There's something for everyone on the Nintendo
Life
Switch
sure
system.
Is Tumblr. I'm done. Dude.
You are Star-Lord, leading a legendary band of heroes for hire in this thrilling action-adventure game.
Oh no, they're gonna have a lot of things that were already shown.
Overwhelm opponents with Star-Lord's daring combat style and encounter iconic Marvel characters. You'll call the shots for the unpredictable Guardians as you face cosmic threats to save the galaxy. You got this.
If it's things they knew would already be Marvel's shown, they should just like put it all in a reel. But then again, it's not like they're spending a lot of time on it, so. Whatever.
Worms everywhere. In this real-time arena-based
that announcer,
shooter,
though.
You'll squish your invertebrate opponents in 32-player cross-platform combat, play in daily challenges, battle modes, and seasonal events to worm your way up the ranks. Plus, the Patchwork Bear outfit, exclusive to the Nintendo Switch version, will be available for free for 2 weeks.
Yeah, that wasn't
launch.
The. That wasn't. That's not my stream. That's the.
Worms Rumble, wriggling.
I think that's the
Nintendo
game.
June 23rd. Get a 25% discount when you.
Yeah, I'm not dropping frames or anything. My internet's fine. I think that's the game. It's working like
the
that.
The fantastical realm of Orcanon awaits. As you explore this fully hand-painted world, you'll customize a team of demigods and unleash devastating attacks and captivating turn-based combat.
The
Astrid
movement
Ascending
looks a
launches
bit strange.
On Nintendo Switch September 30th.
It's 40 minutes long. Kazuya was announced for Smash. That's all you missed so far.
World of Two Point County. In
the fuck is this?
Management sim Two Point Campus. You'll build and run your very own university.
You know, it's fine. Go ahead and get this shit out the way, dude.
Creative tools are at your disposal to make the school yours.
Go ahead and get this shit out the way.
Empire to the next level. Enrollment for Two Point Campus starts on Nintendo Switch next year. A beloved series rolls into its 20th.
I'd rather all this shit come at the beginning than like in the middle or the end. You know what I mean? Oh, I know my chat's about to pop off. Yahoo! I know my chat's about to pop off, dude. Oh, I know T-Bun's gonna be excited. Oh my god. These motherfuckers were arguing with me last week about, like, oh my god, like, no, Shulk, you don't understand. We need Monkey Ball. It's so godlike. That's why I heard texting me right now. Shit, hold up.
Go bananas when Super Monkey Ball Banana Mania rolls onto Nintendo Switch October 5th.
That's T-Bun.
It's a blast from parties past, and you're invited.
I knew it.
Ready for another round?
I knew it.
Of course you are. It's a superstar collection of Mario Party boards and minigames. Live it up on five classic boards from the Nintendo 64 era, including Peach's Birthday Cake and Space Land. Each board is packed with zany events guaranteed to keep you on
your toes. Oh, these new boards?
And when we say zany, we mean it. Jump. Connect blocks. And give facelifts? In hilarious over-the-top minigames. All of which support button controls. With 100 minigames from the Mario Party series catalog, you'll have a blast in this all-star fun fest. Here's a little party favor. All game modes work with online play. Even if you're partying solo, you can randomly match with other partygoers worldwide. Playing a board game online with friends? Save your progress mid-game, grab a snack, then resume the festivities. Stickers are also available to communicate with others. It's time to partay in Mario Party Superstars, launching on the Nintendo Switch system October 29th. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop.
What did you think? Before we show this next trailer, I'd like to say one thing. Currently, we're working hard on the latest game in the Metroid Prime series, Metroid
They're not
going to
show Metroid,
4,
yeah.
Which we previously announced. But today, we'd like to introduce another new entry in the Metroid franchise.
Oh, 2D!
Please take a look.
2D! Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Fucking rip my headphones out. Oh my fucking god. Oh my god. I'm lightheaded. Oh my god. I'm dreaming right now.
For the first new 2D Metroid game in roughly 19 years, the brand new Metroid Dread game. As the name Dread implies, this is a Metroid game with a new feel, showcasing a variety of threats that Samus will encounter. It's scheduled to be released on October 8th, so it won't be too long until launch.
Oh my!
On that same day, we'll also be releasing amiibo figures for Samus and the Emmy, the robot seen in the video. Let's move on to more Nintendo Switch headlines.
These familiar franchises are back on Nintendo Switch. Get ready to get down in the latest Just Dance game. Hit the dance floor in Just Dance 2022, launching on Nintendo Switch November 4th.
No way.
The arcade smash.
I'm awake right now.
Nintendo Switch. Blast your way through nearly 30 over the top
tracks.
Crimson,
thanks for that follow, dude.
Up to four
There's
players
no
can race together.
No fucking
to pick your
way.
And hit the road.
Bro, there's no fucking way, dude.
Blast launches as a console exclusive on Nintendo Switch this fall. It's the ultimate Dragon Ball Z experience. Relive the story of Goku and other Z fighters through four sagas in this action RPG. Saiyan, protect the Earth from an invasion by Vegeta and Nappa. Frieza, take a stand against the evil Emperor. Cell, battle the androids in a fight to the death. Majin Buu, an epic showdown with the most fearsome foe. Along with the main story, you can explore the vast world of Dragon Ball Z. Hey, why not help out
like,
the locals?
If you guys aren't Metroid fans,
meals. You could always train to acquire new skills too.
Like, y'all have to understand that as far as, like, the story goes, the last part of the Metroid story was, like, back in 2002. Like, Fusion was the latest one in the Metroid story. So, like, they haven't actually moved the story forward since 2002. Fusion was, like, 2002.
Into each of the modes.
And it finally got a sequel that...
Take your time to read the wind and terrain on the greens.
Nice shot.
Hit different types of shots and aim for under par.
Nice first.
Dude.
Speed golf. Smack your ball, then chase after it. Be the first to get your ball.
Dude, Fusion is one of the best 2D experiences you will just ever get, period.
And special shots.
Right take? Like...
Battle Golf. Duke it out over 9 flag-marked holes in an obstacle-filled arena.
Holy after 3 flags to win. Shit. I'm fucking... Golf I can feel myself by like, starting to sweat.
...to pro with your Mii character.
Under my armpit.
Challenges that await may surprise you.
See, like, I knew there wouldn't be a Prime 4.
And here's some news.
I knew Prime 4 was not gonna be ready to be shown, because, like I said, it just restarted development in 2019. But that... is
the fairways almost
that's arguably better
tea time and get ready to ace those shots.
You know, because at least the last Prime game was like 2007.
June 25th,
the last 2D Metroid that actually like moves the story for like the next real 2D Metroid came 19 years later. Like holy shit, that was a better announcement than showing Prime 4. That was like games ago, and I'm still talking about it. I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry.
A monster companion.
I'm sorry. Like.
Gather materials such as honey and ore.
I'm sorry. Yeah, you have to understand. That was like a wet dream announcement. I'm so sorry. I'm gonna try to like focus. Although there's not really anything for me to focus on right now.
Some are docile, but others may suddenly.
What I'm saying, like having a Metroid 5 is a bigger deal than having a Prime 4.
Weapons and skills to overwhelm
you see what I'm saying?
Monsters in turn-based battles. Win, and you'll be rewarded with their materials.
It's a way bigger deal than having a Prime 4. Yo, Session, thanks for the 105 bits, dude. Appreciate that.
You might be able to hatch a new monster. Incredibly powerful monsties can also hatch from rare eggs.
This fucking monster sperm, dude. I really wish they thought join up monsties. With friends Holy for co-op shit.
Multiplayer quests and battles.
I don't know about that, fanboy. I don't know.
It's going to be a real monster of an
I don't know about that, man.
Monster Hunter Stories.
I'm so fucking horny right now, dude. I just July 9th. I need a bust right now, like.
You can play the free demo on June 20th. I'm hard as carry over your fuck. Data to the full game.
Okay, let me try to focus back on the conference. Let me.
Here's a new game from the head of a
circle. Oh, new WarioWare.
Did you miss me? Hey, what do you mean? Who am I?
It's a I don't really care for
Wario. Wario.
Cool, I guess.
And it's a finally ready, a brand new game from my company.
I don't really care for like mini game compilations like
you
that anymore.
You control me. Time to do this. Look at me go.
They announced Metroid 5.
They came back and they have wonderful new talents.
They announced Metroid 5, dude.
Not so bad. Use the spinning, whatchamacallit. Ha! Nailed it. Same micro game.
And the fact that like the whole thing about Metroid Dread was real this entire time. Like that's what made it even crazier. Like, wow. That's Metroid Dread. Like that shit has been talked about for so long.
Better get ready for some micro game mayhem.
The WarioWare Get It Together game launches exclusively on the Nintendo Switch system September 10th. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop.
What you just saw was the trailer for WarioWare Get It Together. In the latest installment of this series, there are new microgames that let you control Wario and his friends. There is also a two-player.
I mean, the rest of the direct so far is like, eh. The gameplay. But it's releasing. But Metroid 5, so man. Tuned.
Next, please take a look at this.
Guys, if you're watching another stream that's ahead, please don't tell us what's coming up. But yeah, Shinigami, don't do that.
As a high school student living in Tokyo, your life is fairly normal. But that reality is upended.
Good job, Nelly.
Into a different dimension.
Yeah, this is Shin Megami Tensei 5. Was that just me or was the audio like cracking out?
Another Tokyo exists. A post-apocalyptic world. Where angels and demons reside.
Nintendo needs to get better, like, announcers or presenters. They're always just so corny
suddenly,
sounding.
You fuse with a mysterious figure.
Of course I already reacted to it. It already happened.
Fight demons. What lies ahead in this alternate realm?
I couldn't tell you. I've never played a Shin Megami. I played like a demo of like one that was on 3DS, but that's pretty much it. Wasteland.
Though friendly demons do exist here, many are hostile and will attempt to destroy you. Harness your newfound powers to.
You sure about that, fanboy? You sure that wasn't corny?
Finding their weak.
I'll definitely be uploading it to YouTube and Twitter.
By targeting it, the number of consecutive actions you can perform in a combo will increase. Though demons are formidable opponents, you may be able to recruit them via negotiations, which begin when you open.
Oh, I didn't realize that mechanic in Persona 5 was from Shin Megami. I didn't realize that. Upload a Pornhub too? Sure. I'm gonna put that bitch up everywhere.
If a negotiation is successful, a demon will become a.
Dude, there is nothing Nintendo can show. There's nothing they can show for the rest of this presentation cases, that's bigger than Metroid 5.
By rejecting a demon's request,
there's nothing.
They feel motivated and join you as an ally. Demons that do join
no, Xenoblade 3 would be like
stronger.
Peanuts compared to Metroid 5.
By fusing demon allies,
Breath of the Wild 2 was already announced. We already know that exists.
The new
F-Zero?
Demon's innate abilities will vary. Granting you a powerful ally, customized to your needs and playstyle.
But that's not gonna happen.
Challenge the many demons roaming this post-apocalyptic world by harnessing the power of your own.
It's good to actually like see this game after so much time, you know.
What destiny will you choose?
Looks pretty good. This might be the first one I
dive into. Nintendo Switch November 12th. Pre-orders for the physical version begin June 21st.
Looks good.
That was the latest trailer for Shin Megami Tensei.
We're at 11:25, so we have about 15 more minutes.
This is the newest game in the series. Please look forward to future updates. Let's see a few more Nintendo Switch headlines.
Celebrate 10 years of Danganronpa in despair.
Oh, Kuro's coming. Is that my boy Monokuma?
Of the school broadcast system.
You know, actually, don't
Three games in the deadly Danganronpa series are coming to Nintendo Switch.
I am this school.
Monokuma, the self-proclaimed school headmaster, has trapped you and other high school students in a game of literal life and death. Unfortunately, the only way out of the school and this lethal game is to betray the other students. And so it begins.
A body has been discovered.
I'm trying not to talk about Metroid 5.
Their demise, a class trial will take place to reveal the culprit.
You're the culprit, aren't you?
I'm cautiously like just holding. I'm just move the body there. You know, I'm trying to not annoy you guys. You know, like
guilty party.
Sneak attack.
I'm trying not to just like talk over the rest of the presentation and all that shit, dude. Like.
Plus, the board game from Danganronpa V3 Killing Harmony has been expanded into a standalone game. Danganronpa S Ultimate Summer Camp. An all-star cast of characters from the Danganronpa series will come together to battle at a tropical resort. Who's the strongest of them all in this ultimate beach brawl? The four-game collection Danganronpa Decadence launches as a physical exclusive on Nintendo Switch later this year. All four games will also be individually available on Nintendo eShop.
Fatal Frame?
We hope you're not afraid of ghosts.
Oh, is this the one on Wii U that's like ported over? Or is this new?
In this horror adventure game, you'll uncover the mysteries surrounding the ethereal but deadly.
I can remember like the subtitle for the one.
To be at the center of many disappearances, ghosts frequent this mountain. Your only defense is a camera that can repel and cast them out. Face your fears as you explore a variety of unsettling locations. This spine-chilling story features various.
Didn't this game only
letting you experience?
Wasn't this only released out here in the West
new
digitally?
New costumes and photo modes are included in this version.
If I'm remembering
Can
that correctly.
Can you investigate Mount Hikami and stay alive? Fatal Frame, Maiden of Black
Water. Yeah, it was digital only. Yeah,
Nintendo
yeah.
Nintendo Switch this year.
So that's actually big then, yeah, because now people are able to buy it out here physically.
Soon.
That's
some even
that's,
today.
That's a nice announcement. I don't care for it, but I'm happy for you guys.
Your war is not over. Raise hell in the first campaign expansion for Doom Eternal, The Ancient Gods Part 1.
Oh my god, that shit looked like some GameCube.
Deeper and more challenging combat awaits as you eliminate hell's newest threats in demon-infested
ruins. That shit looks like Unreal 2004.
The fate of the cosmos
I'm exaggerating,
is in your hands.
But...
Get slaying when this campaign expansion launches on Nintendo Switch later.
Ah, man, don't say that, man. Don't say that. Chill.
Get ramped up for two iconic skateboarding games fully remastered in HD.
Wait, was this not already on the Switch?
Jams as the legendary Tony Hawk and a roster of new and returning pros. Take your sessions on the go with all the original game modes. And compete locally or online to show off your tricks against other skaters.
I could have swore
Drop
it was.
Into Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 1 and 2, launching on Nintendo Switch June 25th. Pre-orders are available now on Nintendo eShop. After 4,000 years, Satechi, the Witch Queen, has risen from the dead, and only one group of heroes can stop her. The Strange Brigade. In this thrilling adventure, you'll blast through an army of mummified monstrosities while solving puzzles in booby-trapped
dungeons. My baby Samus finally getting her just due. Metroid fans, we eating good today, baby!
Expect the unexpected.
We eating hella good.
Launches on Nintendo Switch later today.
Metroid is fucking back. We got Metroid 5 and Prime 4 still on the way, man. Like, man, it's been so hard as a Metroid fan, man. It's been so hard
to restore order to the galaxy. Our heroes must stop a mysterious new evil from plunging the universe into chaos.
It's been so hard, man. Like, all we got was, like, bits and pieces and crumbs here and there. Like, it just takes so long to get to the next Metroid game, you know what I mean? Like,
and even quirkier secrets. And in this fresh take on the tactical genre, our heroes can run freely around the battlefield, creating new strategic and chaotic possibilities. So,
Night, that game does not exist.
With a little help from your friends.
Wait, who's that?
That game does not fucking exist.
Well, one thing's certain. This is gonna be one heck of a galactic adventure. Mario plus Rabbids Sparks of Hope launches into space or onto Nintendo Switch next year.
Federation Force is not a real game that exists. Advance Wars? Oh, the remaster, the original? Nintendo remember that they have this IP? Oh, shit. Oh, my nigga, Andy. I don't much care for the portraits, but... Dude, finally Advance Wars gets some love. Yes, finally, dude. You've got the seriousness of things. Memorable characters. I don't blame you. Yeah, so did Nintendo until now. Lead the commanding officers to victory. Good announcement. Now there's Advance Wars Days of Ruin on the 3DS, I believe. Or was that DS? I can't remember if it was DS or 3DS. Pre-orders begin today. Oh, that's one answer.
How is everything? All right. This next segment will be our last announcement of the day. Please take a look.
So they're gonna spend 7 minutes on something. This is not your last announcement. This is not your last announcement. Cause they're not about to spend 7 minutes on Age of Calamity. That's cap. There's no way they're about to spend 7 minutes on Age of Calamity. They have to pivot to Breath of the Wild 2. They have to. Okay, yeah, they're not even gonna talk about it. Good.
Hello there, I'm Eiji Aonuma, producer of the Legend of Zelda series. What you've just seen is a trailer for the first wave of DLC for the Hyrule Warriors Age of Calamity expansion pass from Koei Tecmo Games. It will follow Link and his allies through more battles that took place 100 years prior to the events of the Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. I hope you'll look forward to it. I have a few more things to share with you all today. We'll begin with the Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword HD game, which launches next month.
Oh, I forgot about that completely.
You'll immerse yourself in the role of Link by using two Joy-Con controllers for intuitive
motion controls,
or by playing in handheld mode, wielding the sword via flicking the stick and button-only controls. This game depicts the oldest era in the Legend of Zelda series, the story of how it all began. What is the origin of the Master Sword? Why did a woman named Zelda become the legend for future generations? These will all be unraveled in this game.
I like Skyward Sword, but I'm not about to spend $60 to play of Zelda, again.
Skyward Sword HD.
I fuck with Skyward Sword HD, but I'm not about to spend $64.
Next up. Here's a little something you might like. This is a Game & Watch system that lets you play three games in the Legend of Zelda series. This year, the original Legend of Zelda game reaches its 35th anniversary.
No Switch Pro. Unless they're going to announce it like
or other Nintendo Switch games planned.
Post E3.
We've been working on this Game & Watch system as a special item to help mark the occasion and reflect fondly on the earliest days of the Legend of Zelda.
Yeah, they really are.
It will come with the first game in the series, The Legend of Zelda, Zelda 2, The Adventure of Link, and the Game Boy version of The Legend of Zelda, Link's Awakening game.
I will give a score at the end, at the conclusion.
A special version of the Game & Watch title Vermin, starring Link as the playable character. So that's four games on one system.
The Switch Pro isn't a Legend of Zelda game. Like, it's a real
pick up and play game Vermin. In addition, regarding the watch functionality for the
like Washington Post and Forbes aren't making shit up. Those are some of the most like reputable publications you could even think of. Like, they're not just making shit up.
You can play with both of them.
We know it's real.
We hope you'll enjoy playing this Game & Watch system whenever and wherever you'd like. All right, here's the last thing we have to show you.
Breath of the Wild.
This is the sequel to The Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild.
Okay.
2 years have passed since we first announced this game, and we've been unable to share any.
Let's see it, baby!
However, development has been steadily progressing. For today, we've prepared some new footage to show a bit more of the game. Please take a look.
We don't need to see Splatoon 3. We already know what Splatoon 3 is going to look like without even seeing it. They don't need to show it. It's Splatoon. How different could it be? You know? That's why Man of War is not in here, because he already knew they weren't going to show it. Wait, huh? My man's got different hair. So is that the Hyrule from OOT? Damn, that wasn't enough for me. That wasn't enough.
So, what did you think? This time around, the setting for the adventure has been expanded to include the skies above Hyrule. We'd like to ask you to wait a bit longer. We're aiming for a 2022 release, so I hope you'll look forward to it.
That wasn't enough. They didn't really
How was that?
Like, they showed That's gameplay, but like I wanted to see like some combat, some hack and slash
type shit on a number of other games we didn't show today. I hope you'll continue looking forward to
That's not the showcase I was wanting. Switch.
Thank you for watching.
I'm going to give it a 7. And I wholeheartedly admit bias. 95% of that 7 is Metroid 5 alone. Thinking objectively, though, or thinking from the mindset as someone who does not fuck with Metroid, they don't care for Metroid, I could definitely understand why someone would give that, like, a 5. Or, like, a 5.5 or a 6. I'll give it a 7. Metroid 5 carried the fuck out of it. But if anyone gives it like lower than that, if someone gives it like a 5, I understand why someone gave it a 5. You know what I mean? Like, I wouldn't disagree or argue with them type deal. I'll give it a 7 though. I'll give it a 7. What was I expecting? Nothing. I wasn't expecting anything.